How have you traumatized your parents? This happened the summer after my senior year of high school. After a long night of drinking, I came home and apparently felt the desire to puke. My parents live on the third floor, I live on the second, and have a bathroom on my floor. For some reason I turned the fan on when I went into the bathroom, which is kinda loud, and my parents' room is pretty much right above the bathroom. So I puked hard, mostly in the toilet at first. I get hot and really sweaty when I'm puking, so naturally I strip down to my boxers. I then somehow manage to puke all over myself. Well, that's unacceptable to drunk me, so I guess I decided to take a shower to clean up. Never managed to turn the water on. Next thing I know, I'm getting woken up by my mother screaming bloody murder, crying profusely. Apparently I passed out in the tub. The fan woke my mom up in the middle of the night, so she came to investigate and found me nearly naked, covered in my own puke, passed out in the bathtub with, she says, my eyes rolling into the back of my head. She thought I was dead. I would say that was a bit traumatizing for her. TLDR. My mom found me passed out covered in puke in the bathtub and thought I was dead. I think being covered in puke should be unacceptable to normal you. I was 3 or 4 and wrecked my tricycle and hit my head on my sister's bike pedal, who was riding right beside me. I hit an artery and my white shirt turned red before I got back inside to show her. She still freaks out thinking about it. You actually got really lucky. If you did indeed hit an artery, as an adult you probably would have died if you didn't have someone there who knew how to deal with the situation. Tourniquet and 911, etc. But as a child, your arteries will actually clot and the bleeding will typically stop itself before you die or even pass out. When my sister was about 2, she climbed up on the bathroom counter, grabbed my father's razor, and proceeded to brush her teeth with it. Luckily all she did was nick her tongue with it, but the amount of blood was awful. The thought of this made me hyperventilate. When I was younger, my parents took one of my toys away from me, a brand new mother freaking Hulk toy. This made toddler me angry, so I did the only logical thing to do. I crap in their room. I crap all over their bed and floor. I reminded my mom about it and she said it wasn't just crap, but diarrhea. I sprayed diarrhea all over my parents' bedroom. When I was young, maybe around 5 or 6, I was trying to find Christmas presents in closets or under beds, but instead I found a crap load of condoms and adult toys. At the time I didn't know what they were, so I opened up the box of condoms, thinking it was a balloon. I started to run downstairs with what I thought was a sword, celeb, and trying to blow up the condoms. I then ran into the room where my parents were and started telling them how I finally found my Christmas presents. My parents still talk about that today. XX Christmas came early that year. After my first BJs, I rushed home to tell my best friend in the world at the time. I got on Facebook chat and told him every dirty detail. I then left my Facebook open when I went to shower. My mom, after arriving home, went to check her email and learned about my new steamy adventures. When I was 7 or 8, I did a science project on the antibacterial efficacy of various soaps. Basically involved keeping hands dirty for a day, pressing grubby thumbs into petri dishes full of agar, then washing and doing the same again. I'd take tracings of the cultures. Bigger colonies were bad, smaller ones good. This ended up winning the county science fair for my grade in a large metropolitan area, so that was nice. But before that, after I'd finished the experiments but before I'd discarded the dishes, I got into a dispute with my parents. Don't remember what about. I thought, I'll show them. So I took the nastiest culture and swabbed it onto their bedroom doorknob. They both got sick as dogs and I had to take care of them for a couple of days. Served me right. TLDR. I waged bacteriological warfare against my parents using my science project. But I told them long ago and we laugh about it now. I like the way you think. My dad was fixing this big butt closet one day. The closet was very old and had an extremely heavy door. The problem with that closet was that the door hinges was loose. At that time I was about 8-9 years old, and my little sister was fooling around inside the closet while my dad was trying to tighten the hinges. He told me to get her out of there, since she was just bothering him, and as I lifted her up, The goddamn closet door fell down on my pinky toe. It's all a blur, but I clearly remember me running down the hallway screaming my heart out while my sock got pumped with blood. After that I passed out, waking up a while later in the backseat of my father's car, with a shitload of toilet paper around my foot. My dad didn't say a word. When I arrived at the hospital I got drugged down and operated. Fortunately, they managed to put my pinky toe back where it belonged. I'm guessing my dad felt very shameful after the incident. However, my mom told me a couple of years ago that after I lost my toe, he immediately put it inside his mouth. Because he had read that that was the only way to save the toe from dying or something like that, and drove to the hospital with the toe in his mouth. I don't think he'll forget that. When I was 13, I was about as frisky as you'd expect a 13-year-old to be. The problem was, I was living in a very religious household at the time. My parents go through phases. This was their religious phase. Luckily for me it was while I was going through puberty, and my parents had an ironclad parental filter on the interwebs, so pee was out of the question. So I decided to draw my own pee. And I'm a pretty dang good artist when it comes to drawing things that are right in front of me to look at. So what I'd do is, I'd take magazine pictures of women who had relatively little clothing on, and just edit out the clothing as I was drawing. Well, of course, my parents found my stack of drawings eventually. Which isn't too bad I guess. My dad even said uncomfortably that I had some talent at drawing and should pursue it, just with different subject matter. Here's the part that makes me cringe. My mother decided that one of the drawings looked too much like her. It was purely coincidental. It was literally a picture out of an advertisement that I had copied to the best of my ability. And she asked me, very uncomfortably, if I fantasized about her. Ladies and gentlemen, not much in the world makes you want to crawl into a hole and die more than when your own mother thinks you've been fantasizing about her. Nothing came of this. She asked if it was her. I said no. It was really, really awkward for a while, and then we moved on. And she asked me, very uncomfortably, if I fantasized about her. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. You know how your parents told you to never run with scissors? Well, I did not listen. I was running through the house like a retard, and I tripped. The scissors went through my front teeth and jammed in the back of my throat. Blood sprayed out my mouth and nose. It frightened my parents so much that my mom passed out, and when she fell her face was smashed on the floor. So I had to get 3 sticks. My mom had $30,000 worth of face surgery, so I figurally and literally traumatized my parents. That's pretty close to a worst case scenario right there. Ouch. One time during my sophomore year in college, I had been feeling guilty for not seeing my family very often, even though they live 20 minutes away, so I decided to take them out to dinner. Since I had some extra cash, I thought I would take them out somewhere nice, so we all went to Black Angus. I thought it would be cool to bring my boyfriend that I had been dating seriously for 6 months. No one in my family normally does this. I find out later that my dad was scared shitless that I was either going to tell the family I was either pregnant or getting married at that dinner. My mom has walked in on me fapping. Not the best way to tell my mom I'm growing up, she later told my dad, who simply said okay, good for him. When I was 2 or 3, my parents had me in the backyard. I was running around and generally being a small child, you know how it is. Apparently I saw something cool on the ground, and like most children my first reaction was to put this fancy thing in my mouth. The fancy thing was bird crap. My mom screamed and took a hose to my mouth. Bonus. I'm a huge misophobe now. I hated school in 4th grade. Terrible teacher. A few bratty other students made going to school miserable. So I loved any excuse to get out of school for all or part of the day, even if it was a doctor's appointment. One day, for some reason, my doctor's appointment was cancelled. I was having none of this. I barricaded myself in my bedroom, no lock on the door, just my desk chair and some stuffed animals as a blockade, and screamed that I would rather die than go to school. My mom was freaked out, crying hysterically and everything. My poor dad, having to deal with 2 hysterical women girls at once. The next day I had an emergency session with mom's therapist. It's good you got to a therapist, but I think your mom overreacted. A lot of kids say they'd rather die than do something. Becoming hysterical over it is an overreaction. I traumatized my mother twice. Both times when I was about 3 years old. The first time we were walking through the botanic gardens and there was a wedding taking place. Apparently the bride was a larger lady, and I piped up in my piercing little voice, "Mummy, look at that fat bride." My mother grabbed me under one arm and ran away. She thinks the bride didn't hear, but she certain some of the guests did. The second time I traumatized her, she took me to her work one day and I met one of her colleagues. He was from Ghana and had very dark skin. Apparently I said, "Mummy, look at that dirty man." Mum said she just wanted the floor to swallow her up. But the guy handled it with exceptional grace and just laughed and said, "Don't worry, at least I can't blush." Yeah, I'm surprised I wasn't left at an orphanage after those two episodes. I now have kids of my own who are determined to give me my comeuppance. In my senior year of high school, I talked about dropping out of school. They threatened to kill me, kick me out of the house and dump me in front of a US Marine recruiting station. In that order. When I was a kid, I would walk my mom to the stove and tell her I smelled gas. When she would take a whiff, all the disgusting goodness of a well-timed fart would go in her nose. Till this day, if anyone say they smell gas, she covers her nose and walk the other direction. All the while saying, "Get out of here, you pig. I am dying right now." I played the game RuneScape for a while when I was 9 or 10 and I got fairly addicted to it, to the point where I stole my parents' credit card and spent close to $1,500 of their money to buy RuneScape gold from a website. I've paid them back since, with interest, but I feel like crap about it all the time. I tried to kill myself by hanging, but failed. I was lazy, so I just threw the rope in the trash. Later my dad found it and checked my room. I played Super Mario 64 at a new friend's house until 3 a.m. when I was 9. The cops were called, a search party sent out, no regrets. You didn't choose the thug life chose you. I was 3 years old when my brother was born. When he was just a few days old, my mom put him in his baby swing, turned it on, and left the room to answer the phone. Well, while she was gone, the swing stopped and my brother started crying. Being the concerned older sister that I was, I pulled him out of the swing and drug him to my mom, saying, "Mommy, the baby is crying." She freaked the heck out and never left him in his swing again. I'd freak out too if my 3-year-old drugged my newborn baby. To this day, when my mom hears the sound of a shopping cart behind her, she protects her heels. It wasn't intentional. I was just an enthusiastic shopping helper. I used to sleepwalk as a young kid and scream the house down and refuse to be touched by anyone while I was in that state. I was a creepy possessed kid in a horror film, and I terrified my parents. I told my parents that my GF needed an ultrasound. She really just needed a small ovary checkup, but it was more fun just to let my parents worry. I approve of your style. I attempted suicide in my parents' car a few months after high school. I remember there was an incredible amount of blood, like buckets of it sloshing around in my seat. About a year later, my dad and I were having something of a heated discussion when he says to me, "No one in this family but me saw what that car looked like the morning after. He still has the car and uses it now and then. I will never be able to understand how much I've hurt him. Dude." When I was in high school, I was very bulimic. If someone was downstairs after I ate dinner, I wouldn't be able to go into the bathroom, so my brilliant plan was to go upstairs and puke into grocery bags. I found this to be way easier than using the bathroom. In the comfort of my room, I could throw up in peace and not be worried of getting caught. Of course, I couldn't throw them away when they were home, so I kept them around my room. I had vomit bags everywhere, under the bed, in my desk drawers, in my closet. It wasn't pretty. One day I went out with a friend and came back at around 3 to get my clothes for work. My stepdad was in his living room and I could hear the wet dry vacuum. I asked why he was cleaning in a joking way and my mum turned around and said, "Cleo, our dog, got into your room today." I instantly was mortified. I went into the living room and my stepdad refused to acknowledge me. There was old puke everywhere. On the stairs, on the floor, in my room, on the couch. Oh god, it was horrible. One of the worst experiences with bulimia I've ever had. When I was little, I thought trashing their room and bathroom was a great idea and absolutely nothing was wrong with it. I took toothpaste, shaving cream, shampoo, conditioner, all that jazz, and just squeezed it all over the place. Over the bed, pillows, carpet, sheets, bathtub, sinks, counter, toilet, tile floor, down the hallway. One nice long trail of toothpaste was so cool. Why I thought this was a great idea, I have no clue. I was grounded for a very long time. When I was about 6, I made up a long list of symptoms to fake sick in order to get out of school. Turns out my symptoms very consistent with malaria. My dad had a job with the US Embassy and we were living in Lagos, Nigeria at the time. I had no idea why they were so worried. Never told my mom about getting a tattoo. Just texted her a photo after I got my half sleeve. She refused to believe it was actually mine until I saw her a week later. When I was little, my parents said that I always used to take off all of my clothes and run around. I did this several times at parties that they had. I'm a stripper now. They should have been proud that you had found your calling. When I was 4, my family lived on the beach. I like to go out on the shore and explore, throw rocks, and whatnot. We had some neighbors I was always interested in because they always had big parties. One day, I decided I wanted to go. I walked over and joined the party, playing with kids and eating hot dogs. Nobody thought otherwise, because they assumed I was somebody's son. I come back a few hours later, last hot dog in tow, to find my parents had called the police trying to find me. They asked where I was and I just told them I was at the neighbor's and they gave me hot dogs. Didn't get in trouble, but I didn't get to visit the neighbors much after that. At age 6 I got attacked by a German shepherd belonging to a neighbor because I pulled its tail, mangled my left bicep and required 36 stitches to fix up. At 13 I fell through a bathroom window, sliced open my elbow, in the process half severing an artery and tendon and cutting my left calf open down to the bone. 53 stitches for that episode. At 17 I crashed my car into a tree on a gravel back road, walked out of that with only a broken thumb. At 20 I took a job as a bouncer and after half a year was stabbed in the right forearm by a chick with a broken champagne flute because I threw her boyfriend out for punching her. Only 4 stitches this time. At 24 Christmas just gone, my appendix burst. I died on the operating table, was brought back and thankfully fought through it, only to almost die again a week later when my heart rate hit 198 and temp went up to 40.6 due to septicemia. I had 82 staples for that one and it's led to my favorite scar ever that runs the length on my abdomen. You could say I've made an art of terrorizing my poor mother, haha. I was severely afraid of the dark as a kid. I would hide under my covers and not get out of bed while it was dark. But I often had to urinate late at night. So I came up with the clever plan of keeping empty Snapple bottles nearby. But I was too grossed out lazy to get rid of them the next day. So my mom finds all these full bottles on the shelf next to my bed. I guess urine starts to smell pretty bad when it's been sitting for a few months. My parents entered my room when I was fricking my boyfriend. It was also when they realized I was gay. D. Woe THX for the upvotes. I couldn't believe it at first. Comma my parents started knocking on the door after that incident. Yeah, that'll do it all right. For the first time in my life I have a perfect story for Ask Reddit and I'm 4,000 comments late. Owl. I was about 2-3 years old at the time and living at my grandmother's house with my aunt. Parents were away on business in Poland. Oh, this was while I still lived in Russia. One day after we hosted a family gathering, my aunt decided to take a nap on the couch, and I do not remember this at all, but apparently I decided to pick up an empty champagne bottle from the previous night and smack her in the face with it. Yep, the way my grandmother tells it is that she was in the kitchen making dinner when she heard my aunt start wailing and crying. So she goes outside. Our kitchen was in the other building. Just the other side of the yard from the main building with the rooms and whatnot. To see my aunt going down the stairs into the yard with blood all over her face and clothing. Crying and carrying a blood covered me in her arms. Also crying. Her eyebrow to this day is split and hair will not grow where she had to get stitches. No recollection of this even a little bit from me. None. My grandparents used to live on the lake. And I love to go on boat rides. I was about 3 years old and I was with my family at the house. I kept saying, go for boat ride, over and over again. All of a sudden I was gone. apparently naked too. The walk from the house to the lake is 50 plus steps down a hill. My mom found me standing on the dock by the boat saying go for boat ride. She was not amused. Not me, but my little sister. When I was in 4th and 5th grade, my dad was in the Air Force and we were stationed at the NATO base in Iceland. My parents were out at some party at the officers' club and there was a girl babysitting my siblings while I stayed at a friend's house. My sister decided to play hide and seek with the sitter. Well, the sitter looked for her for over an hour and got scared that she had left the house. She called the O Club and had my parents paged. They left the general's table in a hurry and turned the house upside down. Couldn't find her anywhere. The MPs were called and hours went by. They literally sealed off the entire base. No one in or out of any gate and all planes were grounded. And put the whole police force and the entire group of KC-135 crew members there on TDY out looking for her everywhere. Around 1 a.m. she finally came out of the coat closet she had hidden in after she was awoken by all the commotion of the cops' radios going off. Apparently she had fallen asleep on the floor in there under some coats. My mom had looked in that closet numerous times, but didn't pull everything out of it. TLDR. My sister almost caused an international incident. My girlfriend and I were in my room having the steamy times. We had pretty much finished and were just talking and cuddling on the floor. We hear my dad coming upstairs but think nothing of it, as the door is shut and he typically knocks. He does knock, but he has a question for me. So he starts talking and pushes the door open. Crap, I'm facing away from the door, but my girlfriend is facing me. Everything's too quick. We don't have any time to cover or shove crumpled clothes in front of our bodies. My dad opens the door and is assaulted with full frontal nudity. He is stunned for a moment, then turns quickly and says simply, "Get her, a peek and line." But unfortunately our dog had followed dad upstairs and wanted to check in with my girlfriend and I. Dad came back 5 seconds later, cracked the door just wide enough for the dog to escape and told him to get out. It was an awkward dinner. Congrats on the freaking. When I was 16, my baby brother, who was 4 or 5 at the time, found me in the bathtub with my wrists cut open. Worst part was that I had, in the fog of depression, somehow decided to shave my face before cutting myself and drawing a bath. For the next 2-3 months after, I had to sleep sandwiched between my parents after they wrapped my arms with fresh gauze and ointment. Not my proudest moment, but that's how I traumatized my parents. I had cancer when I was 6. I was basically never allowed to do anything for fear of me dying, both during chemotherapy and well into my remission, rocking 17 years now. I overdosed on H in the bathroom. They broke down the door to find me lying there dead. I was pronounced dead upon my arrival to the hospital, but they managed to revive me. When I was a young lad, I would embarrass my family after every bath. Prepubescent me would take a bath, dry off, and stretch my scrotum over my willy. Then, I would run around the house stark naked yelling him the gingerbread man, "You will never catch me," to the horror of my mom, dad and 2 sister. When I was about 5, we had a babysitter while my parents went out with some friends. While they were out I cut myself, and the babysitter and I went to get a bandage from the master bathroom. I found some interesting things and the babysitter told me to ask my mom what they were, as she didn't know. Babysitter put me to bed. Parents came home with lots of friends for a few more drinks, and I strolled into the living room, fists full of tampons, saying, "Mommy, what are these?" If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.